The city has moved to mandatory water restrictions because the voluntary ones just weren't working. Now, a few years ago when the city did this, a lot of people started calling around and complaining that they'd seen their neighbors using their water hose and whatnot. Well, you're allowed to use your water to take care of your beautiful crepe myrtle like I am here. It's the sprinklers and whatnot. That's where the mandatory restrictions come in.
Greensboro residents can use sprinklers only on garbage day. Any other time during the mandatory water restriction period is illegal. City water levels are down at Lake Townsend. They're down 51 inches, down 30 inches at Lake Brandt. The city has less than 150-day water supply. The weather has taken its toll on the city's greenery.
I think you have to work with the city and what your resources are, but I also think you need to do long-range planning for times when you have droughts.
City water officials attended a statewide drought meeting last week in Raleigh before announcing the mandatory restrictions. The bottom line from that meeting, don't expect much rain anytime soon.
The penalty for violating the mandatory water restrictions, first time out it's a warning, the second time it's a $100 fine, the third time it's $200. In Greensboro, Bill O'Deal, WXII 12 News, back to you.